Bishop Clinton Daniel, Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is a privilege to be here with you today in this historic cathedral. And I'm grateful to Bishop Clinton Daniel for the opportunity to speak to you. I'm happy to congregate in an atmosphere which not only reminds us of our fallibility, but also teaches us how we can be better persons, better communities, and better nations. Since I assumed office on 16th September this year, as President of the General Assembly for its 74th session, I participated in an annual prayer service, an international prayer breakfast, and this service today. My participation in these events reminds me of the place of faith in our lives, particularly relating to how to treat others as we would like them to treat us. All my life, I've seen the faith-based organizations' efforts in providing services to the poor and giving hope to the hopeless. In the face of crisis, poverty, hunger, and illiteracy, the church and other religious organizations have acted as first responders, providing succor, feeding millions, building schools, providing shelter, and administering orphanages and hospitals around the world. The role of faith-based organizations that they play in our lives are thus numerous, and this extraordinary love, care, and generosity has been critical in the lives of individuals, communities, and even nations. Religion reminds us of how we are made in the image of God and worthy of His mercy. Either educated or not, powerful or not, and prosperous or impoverished, it also reminds us of how much morals we must not only profess, but reflect in our daily lives. It provides us a gauge for our behavior and instructions for our relationships. Well interpreted, this sets humanity in good stead to achieve peace and prosperity. This has not always been so, as we have seen misinterpretations and misrepresentations of faith by those who interpret religious tenets to suit their own partisan, if not even criminal purposes. It is, however, heartening that when egregious acts have been committed anywhere in the world, leaders of various faiths have risen in condemnation of such acts. These leaders remind us that God's will is for all, and no matter where you are born, to be indeed free from want and live in decent circumstances. They also remind us of the need for tolerance and empathy, as this is key to the fight against all forms of discrimination and injustice. This is not different from what the founding fathers of the United Nations had in mind, an organization which functions to achieve international peace and security. The United Nations, since its inception, has striven with great success to achieve this purpose. Its connection to faith should be therefore very clear. Our faith demands that in the face of need, oppression, and suffering, we must act to bring succor and hope to those in dire need of our generosity, in accordance with holy books and the example of extraordinary men and women of faith. We should therefore continue to emphasize the need for empathy, love, and compassion. With numerous conflicts, crime, terrorism, and climate disasters happening around the world, we must all bond together, no matter what faith we profess, to seek God's guidance to face the challenges we must collectively deal with. I would like, dear colleagues and friends, in conclusion, to thank you once again for inviting me at this great cathedral and to seek your prayers as I begin the task of implementing my vision regarding peace and security, poverty eradication, zero hunger, quality education, climate action, and inclusion. I trust that we will all recommit to God and continue to seek divine interventions for the crisis around the world while also doing our very best to make a positive difference in the life of the vulnerable and the marginalized. I thank you.